Yo, what's up, everybody? We're back. Played a little offline today, and we are on round 10 of 19. It's the Hungarian Grand Prix. So, just gonna run the practice here. I'm just gonna simulate that. Need to switch out the parts, though. Gonna use these damaged parts first. Hope everyone's having a good weekend. Yeah, I did a bit of playing offline. Still P1 in the constructors. Albon still P1 in the drivers. Car's been really dominant. We still have, pretty sure we're still like first and second in downforce cornering. Let's just simulate to qualifying.
Qualifying is coming up, and the drivers will be ready and raring to go.
The Hungaroring shot.
Yeah. I mean, most of it was just pretty quick. But, this one I saw, I was like, alright, I gotta save this one because this is gonna be heavy rain for Saturday, Sunday. Last two races, it was, Silverstone? Yeah, I just did, it was basically just Silverstone offline. I don't think I did, what did I do, the Austrian one too? Wasn't really that exciting, because it was just Albon dominating. But, this one with the rain, I was like, I gotta save this one for the stream. Because there could be some chaos on track. Also, it just allows for a better strategy. It's pretty standard. Silverstone is a two-stop. So for this, now I did purchase a new ERS system for both cars, but we haven't used them yet, and when we do use this, there will be a 10 place grid penalty. I think we can actually still, let's see what happens when we use these 70%. They're not optimal, you know, they're outside of the 74% engine is outside of the optimal performance range for that engine for Ferrari, but should still be good up until 40%. Your save last season, P1 in the drivers with George Russell and P1 in the constructors with McLaren. Left McLaren and joined Alfa Romeo. Oh no. When you joined Alfa Romeo, what was the condition of all their facilities? Were the facilities all, like, you know, did they need to be refurbished? Because I see that happens a lot. When people switch teams, the AI doesn't refurbish their buildings. They just let them deteriorate for some reason. Oh, no. So, yeah, when we switch teams here after this season is done, I'm probably going to walk into a landmine of broken-ass facilities. we're gonna need a bunch of money to spend on refurbishing that. Fun times. All right, here we go. First quality session. Now they start us on the dry compound, so it's probably not gonna rain right away, but all right, looks like about halfway through it's gonna rain, so we gotta get the cars out there immediately. Yeah, once I hit play here, watch the all the cars start coming out.
That's great.
Or at least they should, if they're smart.
Alex, ready to...
Yep, here they come.
Yes, copy.
Yeah, that's lava clear.
Build the front tire, Tim.
Okay.
Ready to check.
Yep, loud and clear. As before, focus on your tire temperature target and the brakes.
Copy.
Just a parade of F1 cars. How much more do we have till the rain? Oh, what's up, William? Hey, I appreciate you, man.
Currently P1, and we are boxing this lap.
Yes, copy.
You're currently P2.
Okay, he's 6/10 off of Albon.
Go in and box.
Copy.
Oh, were you kidding me? What?
Yeah, I made a mistake.
You lock up on your in lap.
Yeah, sorry.
What are you doing? Did you just scrub those tires? Those tires are probably trashed. What's the percentage now? 87%? Everyone else just put 92% wear on it? Bro was rushing to get back into the garage, locked up for no reason.
We expecting more rain to come.
Yeah, copy. We're arriving to the box.
Watch out, white line, pit limiter. Stop in box, on max, all revs and engine off.
Okay, so it's gonna start raining here in like a minute. Can we get one more lap out of these tires? Actually, you know what? I'll give Behrman a fresh, soft tire. Let's see if they can get out there and start a flying lap before the rain. He's dangerously close to being eliminated. Yeah, I think on him the gearbox is 70% versus Amon's 88%. I think that's where the difference in time is coming from. Oh, also, he's using a different... He's using, like, the older spec on car 2. Just like real-life Williams. They have a bunch of extra parts that are older, so... Car 2 is basically just going to use those instead of manufacturing...
Currently P1.
New parts all the time and then eating up the cost cap for no reason.
Go in lap.
Yes, copy.
There's barely an improvement there. Now it's raining. Well, it should start to rain. The sponsors are not going to be happy if you don't make it to Q2.
Oh no.
Alright. Behrman P16. P17. Is it even worth going out again? Nope. It's a damp track already. Alright, just fast forward. Got eliminated. Damn it. It's because I simulated practice. He wasn't 100% prepared. Could have been that too. Although that's a tricky one because it was heavy rain during practice, so... It's hard to do like a long run to get 100% track acclimatization because you have to switch tires. Well, the sponsors are gonna be pissed. We promised them two drivers in the top 10. Stay on a fresh set of softs. Pause it. Check the track details, and we got like 2 minutes before the rain. 5 minutes. No, it's like 4 minutes till the rain. Drivers line up for 2028 season. Verstappen, signs. Leclerc, Gasly.
Let's try and get these brakes fired
Mercedes
up again.
Mercedes, Tsunoda, Schumacher.
Yeah.
Enzo Fittipaldi, man. They really have those young drivers coming up at 2028. Of course, at Aston Martin, never getting rid of Stroll, huh? And Williams took Behrman, nice.
Standard in lap.
Okay, copy.
Another Albon domination session here. No point in going out again. You're not going to get faster than the soft tire time. I don't know why they're wasting their engine power on that. Man, it's even going up to wet tires, even. He's going out again? Are you crazy? You really think going out on wet tires is going to help you get out of Q2 like that? There's no way. It'll just be yellow, yellow, yellow. This is probably why Mercedes is last. They have, I don't know what they're doing. P13, P14. Maybe their car is just really terrible. That's not smart strategy. All right, starting on your intermediate tire. Does it dry out? Only by a little bit. Maybe just wait for some of this water to decrease a bit. Start the flying lap. Alright, Albon purple, sector 1. You get a purple sector 2. Alright, green.
We are P2 currently. That's a good lap, mate. I'm boxing this lap.
Go ahead. Yes. Go game. That was just the warm up. Now we need to get one more lap in. One more flying lap. Just gotta wait for the traffic. That was the last car out of the garage. Oh man, no improvement on the time here.
Currently P5.
Okay.
Okay, Alex.
That's that red light, so go switch in.
Yes, okay.
The time has come to fight it out. It's race day.
The heart may be in Budapest, but the racing soul is right here.
Okay, heavy rain. Now, normally you do a two-stop here. However, we look at the track graph. Wow. It's gonna be dry, intermediate, then wets, and then how many laps is this? Is it like 7 laps, 6 laps of intermediate, and then back onto the wet? Or is it you just stay out? Intermediates at like lap 18. Then yeah, the rain is just gonna start pouring according to this weather chart. For this last part here, we gotta really just pay attention to the water level. Because if it jumps back up over 4, I mean, for 5 laps, this is gonna basically be 5 laps from lap 65 to 70. You can't run 5 laps on the wrong tire because I think you'll just be too slow. I wonder what the AI is going to do. Would they stay on intermediate? Is it like 4 laps of intermediate running on the wrong tire? Yo, top spirit. Thanks for the raid. Wits early. Could be right. Let's see. Gotta modify this. It's gonna be soft tire. Thanks everybody for joining. Top tier, thank you for the raid. Welcome. We got one crazy race coming up. I think this is intermediates right about here. Wet tire. About there, then intermediates, right when the blue crosses the orange. Then early wet tire, let's see, lap 64 perhaps. So we're looking at a, what was this, a four-stop strategy? But with so much rain on the track, that does mean that we can underfuel the car by a lot. The rain starts... Well, once you switch to intermediate, that is, lap 18 or 19. And from then on, we pretty much gain fuel back by going standard pace. So if we have 70 laps, we go down to 65. So I got 5 laps of fuel. And there may even be a safety car or a VSC or something, which also helps gain the fuel back. Yeah, if it's less than... The forecast accuracy, I think we have like one of the, as far as the forecast accuracy, I think it's like 90% accurate. So this is saying only five laps of five laps of wet track, we may be able to get away with it if everyone else stays out. Whatever, I'll just leave it there just to be safe, but we may not need to. And everything is at max pace. All right, let's see what happens.
There's a fantastic atmosphere at the Hungaro Ring as we prepare. And here we go with the Hungarian Grand Prix.
Could you describe the conditions around the track?
And away we go.
Wet. Can't see a thing. Very wet.
We're gonna do medium aggression, but rarely defend. I think I'll just keep Behrman neutral for everything right now.
It's not waste time.
Okay.
It's Ferrari Red Bull out front. Turn one. Survive turn one, okay. Max leading the Ferraris. Of course, Leclerc is going to defend like crazy here and cause a gap. We'll get past maybe by driving in clean air. No. There you go. All right, on to Russell. Maybe hopefully close the gap and get DRS. Behrman down here having a bad time. It's a ton of traffic. Okay, now with DRS.
Toto, it's called a motor race, okay?
Yeah, we're back on low on
track. We went to car racing.
Nice.
Nice work.
All right. Now, we got Max up ahead. He's gapped us, though. He's got a 1 second. Yeah, he's outside of the 1 seconds, but Russell came charging back through the DRS. Miami GP results. Piastri P1, Lawson P4. Piastri first win of the season. Nice. What's Piastri's overall rating in your save? Did the AI train him up to be actually good? I mean, if you got P1, probably, right? '86 or '87. That's pretty damn good. That's pretty basically where I have Albon right now. We have DRS here. Struggling to keep up. I wouldn't say struggling, but just inside of Verstappen's 1 second DRS. Made a little dummy move to the outside, got covered, and then immediately to the inside.
Further rain expected.
Okay.
Sorry, yeah. So, kind of let the tires cook there, but yeah, avoiding curbs definitely helps bring the temps down while maintaining pace. But yeah, I don't think Max is pushing as hard as we were to catch up to him. We're basically, we pushed the tires 5% more than he did to get it to get up to P1. But as long as I keep the tires maybe within 95 degrees, we should be okay. It's working out for Behrman, though. He's climbed up to P14. I could definitely see Ferrari doing a double stack. Classic Ferrari double stack in the rain. It'll ultimately destroy one of these guys' races. Probably Russell, since he's second. And I think if Red Bull double stacks, what's their interval? Yeah, there's like a 4-second gap here. About 5 seconds between Verstappen and Sainz.
And here we've got a yellow flag. Now we're approaching turn two. And the controls lost. And once it started, they were pretty powerless.
Maloney. Maloney all aloney. Alright, now we're in trouble because there's no DRS. Right? Or is there still DRS? No, there's still DRS. But Verstappen definitely pulled away from us. Looks like he's pushing. We could stop avoiding curbs on Behrman. Water on track should cool the tires.
The window is open. Copy.
Right, we're not going into the pits just yet. We're waiting for, what, like 0.8? .8 millimeters of water. Tires are about done, though. Approaching 30%. We should avoid curbs. A 0.5 on the water line. According to our 90% accurate forecast, this should spike up within 2 laps. Okay, Ferrari is not double stacking. Russell pit first. think that's a little early, honestly. Wait till like 0.7, 0.8. We got more coming in. When should I bother pitting? No, it's too late. It's too late now. What was that? Tsunoda and Russell almost coming together. Oh yeah, he's on the wrong tire.
Please confirm all the tires out.
He's at 30% though. It's probably about time here. Point 0.7 on the water. Behrman's got to go in. Can't stay out on a 20-something percent tire.
Copy, Bob.
Next inter.
Verstappen goes in. We can do it next lap.
Okay, box, box.
Box, box. Just hit 0.8.
Set tire switch to inter.
Oh, did I fuck it up?
We're riding to the bump.
The cushion coming in.
Copy.
Damn, that was perfect from Ferrari. Look at that. Russell ahead of Leclerc. Oh, I'm halfway around the track, and I'm on the wrong tire. Damn it. Let's see how bad this fucks up the race. Gonna be behind Leclerc, maybe. Not as bad as I thought it was gonna be. Stop avoiding curbs. But yeah, we definitely would have been smarter to pit. Right when Verstappen pit. But secured fast lap so far. Be about what, 15 laps? Closing the distance, but eating up the tire. It's now a 3-second gap to Verstappen. Going by lap times, Verstappen's doing a 1:23.2. We're on 1:22.5. Joe just parked his car on the side of the road. Okay, now we need Behrman to get back into the top 10, please. Start pushing again once these tire temps come down. Behrman at peak performance, or peak confidence, and then Albon's only at very high. He's been overtaken left and right, though. He's up to P11, so about to pass Tsunoda here. Start using curbs again. Should make the pass now. It's just cooking the tires, damn.
So watch out for track condition.
Track's drying out. Just a little bit. So we're gonna have DRS. Right? DRS is enabled. As long as we keep the same tire percent as Verstappen. I don't think there's any way we're going to catch up to him, though, but... maybe? Still around this, like, 2.5 to 3 second gap. Thank you. Hey William, thanks for joining. Get some rest. Alright, Behrman finally into P10. Can we close the gap to Tsunoda? Oh, the track is damp again. 101. No DRS. Deploy on the straights. Well, what battery? We have like nothing in the battery. And I'm afraid to harvest right now because with no DRS. With no DRS, yeah, it's tough to try harvesting, but yeah.
The window is open.
Yes, copy.
Let's try and build this pack up.
Yeah.
So if we harvest here and then deploy.
We can use the overtake.
Copy.
Because they don't deploy the battery on the actual straight though. They deploy it through the corner leading up to the straight. At least from my observations. I have to exit the corner with extra power. Doesn't seem to be using a lot of it though here. Probably through this hairpin. But keep it on harvest.
Let's get the pack under control.
Okay.
Now deploy.
Let's use the overtake.
Yes, copy.
Back to zero.
Check the DRS.
Yeah, copy.
What we need is like a safety car. Then I can put the car back on harvest. Should really be on top up. That's what it's. The strategy is top up for 5 laps. It should give you 1 megajoule.
Need some recharge.
Could probably use curbs again though. Albon. Alright, we're just waiting. We gotta watch the water chart here though, because there's gonna be a huge spike in rain. Maybe getting out early. Like if Behrman goes early. Next lap. Comes.
Okay, box.
1.5.
Box.
Water level rising. 2 millimeters on track. Go around one more time.
Okay,
Let's see if Max pits here. Up to 3 millimeters. He's got to be pitting at this point, right? Yeah.
Box.
Just be wary, the pit entry is slippery.
Okay.
Oh, we held him up just a little bit, though. He couldn't release the car. Is there coming down the pit lane? Is that a pit stop issue for Ferrari?
Watch the white line on exit.
Okay, we're coming now to the pit.
Cushion, stop
Leclerc. They left Leclerc out to dry. Or stay wet. Charles, what are you doing? You're on the wrong tire. Well, not just yet. It's not wet just yet. But it's getting there. 4 millimeters on track pretty soon.
Here's the replay. Now it's quite wet for those on the track. And the car fails to respond. And they'll need to be mindful of the effect that that had on the tires.
Sergeant, what are you doing? Alright, now it's the clearance of the pit. I don't know if that was the. It could have been. I think that could have been better. They. For Ferrari, at least. I guess they didn't want a double stack. Which is usually. It's unusual for Ferrari. They like to double stack their cars. Don't know why, but the AI tends to do that. Behrman retains P10. And we need to use curbs on Behrman. His tires are too cold.
We've got a yellow flag here.
Two Aston Martins. And he just loses it. Still within 3 seconds of Max, but not closing the distance enough. Almost good to deploy the battery here, though. Like basically, if we cross the line and we're over 50, then we should be able to go on deploy. They're at 46 crossing the line. That's good enough. Okay, I think we might catch up to him this time. Deploy through the corners, final corners. There we go. Okay, 1.1 seconds. Deploying.
Track is currently low.
Okay.
So we got within 1 second of him. And the blue flag just set us back.
You can be aggressive with overtake usage.
Yeah, copy.
Alright, Bearman, now it's your turn. It's going to be another, what, 5 laps? 10 laps? Of top up. So the kind of bad thing is, now that we're so close to him, we're in his dirty air. Plus water. The tire temps are going to be crazy. Alright, Bearman overtakes Tsunoda finally. Now it's DeVries. Just don't want to fall too far behind, because that just would negate whatever we gained here. So we're still within 1 second. We lose time in the straights, but gain time in the corners. We got 15% in the battery extra.
There's a yellow flag now.
Porch chair.
But this is what happened. Now look, here we head into turn two. And round they spin. To be fair though, even the best drivers in the world are going to struggle when the track's like this.
don't know, Max really doesn't seem to be struggling here. It's been definitely a struggle session for Albon, trying to get back into P1. Oh, come on. So close. Watch this blue flag here. Just pull over during the straight, please. Is that Maloney? Or Magnussen? That's Magnussen. Advertising kick. Overcooking the tires by a lot here. It's already gone damp. Seems a bit early, but okay.
And box, box.
Copy, box.
Next inter.
Staying out. They are staying out. Alright. Let's see what happens when we leave Behrman on the leave Albon on wets. No, Russell's pitting now. Max is probably going to be pitting, so we, yeah. Max did not pit. He's staying out on wets. Is that the right call, though? 2.2 second pit stop. Number one. Yeah, I don't know, man. Should have probably switched those tires sooner. If it's gonna dip down lap 60 like that. Alright, now he pit. Ran over that Ferrari guy. Thank you. We're still within 1 second. He's just that good.
Low fuel, so be mindful of that.
Yep.
We'll start the lifting post now.
Copy.
Alright, now we deploy. Deploy and overtake, please, please, please. No! Defended it well.
Currently low on pack.
Yep, copy.
That was so close. Damn, he must be pushing. How much battery does he have? 1.4? Ninety-one on the tires, so he's pushing. Actually kind of surprised there was no safety car. We had a lot of spin-outs and lockups. So I didn't jinx anything by saying that. Can avoid curbs to bring the temps down. We're at a minus 1.2 kilo delta. With 10 laps to go. I think we should be able to cross the line. Yes, I'm well aware the tires are overheating, but not much I can do about that. Unless I want to, you know, if I lower the pace, we're going to break, or Verstappen's going to break away from us. Alright, now here's the moment of truth. Do we switch to the wet tire or not? Yeah, Max is pushing. Must be. Put another 1 second on us. Yeah, his tires are 104. He's cooking his tires. Oh, here it is. Sainz coming into pit. He is going for the wets. All right, we're good on fuel. Yeah, your call of going in early for the wets might be correct here. Let's see, is Max gonna pit or stay out? Max is pitting. And we stayed out. Yeah, we pit. We pit. It's the only way. Okay, we got 5 laps. Leclerc stayed out. They're gonna stay out. It looks like they are gonna stay out. But it's rapidly rising here. 3.8. Here, yeah, now they're pitting. Timed it pretty damn well, but basically kept in line with Verstappen. Alright, our only hope here is to deploy through the last corner, maybe close the gap again. back into 1.5, 1.6 seconds. He's still ahead. Yeah, I know. He's just that good. Somehow can keep pace on a wrong set of tires. His adaptability must be good. But we can push fuel here. We do have a positive fuel delta. Oops, I conserved too much on Behrman. We could push on him for the rest of the race, probably. Reeling him in, though. Point three. Deploy. Blue flag, please don't screw us over. Alright, good blue flag. Didn't try to go for the inside line there. It's too risky on the wet, maybe. Yes, I know the tires are overheating. Doesn't matter at this point. Now, one final deploy. This is all we got.
Are you crying?
Low wall pack.
Why is there a yellow flag? They love spinning out at that one corner.
I just lost the rear.
Oh, that puts Behrman into P8.
Yeah, we're back on lower pack again.
Okay.
Come on. Oh, get out of the way. No. Oh my god. Now he's 1 second away from us. Fucking blue flag bullshit. It's over.
Flag is out.
P2. Well done, guys.
And Ferrari.
Yeah,
Ferrari
3-4.
Still probably not enough to overtake us. Although this is a pretty bad race for Behrman. Should have at least been P6, P7 maybe. I mean, decent recovery, all things considered. Because he started, what, P19?
That would be checkered flag. That's P8.
But yeah, he should have definitely qualified into Q3 instead of getting eliminated in Q1.
Alex Albon put in an absolute showstopper of a drive today.
That was an excellent performance. They set out with a great strategy, and it paid off with an impressive podium finish.
Pure elation there as the driver regroups with a team that worked so hard to see this moment. And there's Alex Albon now, taking to the podium alongside his fellow drivers.
I can't believe we're seeing a ninth podium of the season. Just incredible consistency.
And as far as those three are concerned, well, they'll be leaving Budapest hungry for more.
Albon still leading the drivers' championship. 239 to 166. Ferrari and Red Bull dead even. 261 to 261. What is that? 86 point gap for either team to overtake us. So we have to have like consistently bad races if they're gonna overtake us, but we did pretty well with the DHL as well. The first and fourth fastest pit stop. That was no mistakes on any of those. But yeah. Not the maximum amount of money that we could have earned there, but pretty decent. Oh god, no, not this. Design center. Small fire in the design center that may have been caused by the facility's power supply. You should not continue design and research any car parts while this matter is investigated. I'm afraid we don't have any option in this case. Design center shut down for 12 days. Projects paused for 12 days. That sucks. Where were we at with car parts? It's pretty much all research. We were waiting for ATR hours. F2. Bordolito. Mansell. Ivana Duda. Okay. Reinhold Beck. Okay, side pods manufactured. Yeah, we still have all these spare chassis. Of course, they're the oldest versions, but I think car 2 could probably still stay on it. Underfloor 4, 19%. Same with this underfloor, 19%. We could probably go one more race with those. Alright, now we're up to Spa. Let's just do one driver in the top 10. And one driver on the podium. I'll guarantee a podium for two races. Actually, qualifying streak. One in the top 10 should be achievable.
This weekend, we're in Belgium, in the picturesque province of Liège. This circuit was built in 1921, and even though its length was halved in 1979, The Belgian Grand Prix is...
All right. Weather is light rain during practice, clear skies, and partly cloudy for the race. All right, let's just get practice out of the way real quick. Using the F1 setup site. Okay, I think this is gonna be the race where we take our grid place penalty for the new ERS. Session 14:31:50, still good. 19:34:7, it's getting close for that gearbox. Simulate this one. Gearbox is pretty much done. I don't think the AI is going to have the ability to get me 100% here. Tire.
What are we thinking about tires here? Thank you. We've got an issue.
Yes, stand by.
Okay, now once we get up to 100, I have to switch to a soft set of tires.
Nice to manage the tires.
Hey, Elite, thanks for hanging out.
Lift core increase, please.
Copy.
Okay, for this, same thing. Actually, we'll save the set of soft tires and go back on this hard tire here. Try to get a fast lap out of this one.
And here we've got a yellow flag.
Last laps in P2, P3. Starting in very high confidence for both drivers.
Will practice pay off for the drivers?
I'm thinking, aside from 70% engine, it's still pretty good. I don't know if it's going to be enough to last the season if we want to get on the podium each time. We also take a new engine for Albon. Qualify with the engine. We'll save it for Q3. We do a 70% engine here, 82 battery. 94 gearbox. Alright, let's see what we can do here.
That's great.
So keep the delta negative where you can. Okay, Alex, so go in lap, go switch in lap.
Yep, copy.
1.9 seconds off the pace for Behrman.
Currently P1, so boxing this lap then.
Got it.
Come on, Behrman. Okay, P5. Is 3 minutes going to be enough to do another lap? That was the weirdest turn into the garage I've ever seen. Just angled it 45 degrees. Oh, you bastard. Some bad traffic. Yeah, that's a yellow sector one. He couldn't, he had a lift during Radeon.
That's the checker.
Traffic, here it is. Yellow sector 2. Yeah, no improvement. Go out on the scrub soft here.
So close to zero, but negative.
That's where it goes, brakes on the way in.
Okay.
You are P2, you are P2.
That's a very good lap, very good lap. So you go in, go in.
Copy.
P2 currently. Okay, I think that's a pretty good lap.
Keep focus on the brakes on the way in if you can.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's not going to be enough time to do a second out lap. See where we end up. Okay, both cars into Q3. Here. Do a new engine. New ERS. How much do we have in the cost cap? 28 million left in the cost cap. You have to subtract like about it's like 11 million for the facility fees and salaries and extra, all that stuff. So do we go with the new engine on? Nah. We will, however, use the ERS. Could use the 95% engine here. Give Albon a brand new car. So 100% ERS engine and gearbox.
That's great.
Let's get some good stops on the brakes.
Yes, copy.
P1. Let's go in that.
Copy.
Remember the front brakes and front tire temp.
Yes.
Currently P1. Let's just focus on brakes on the way in, brakes on the way in.
Yep, copy.
P6.
This lap was okay.
Okay, yeah, go in, go
not
in.
Not a huge improvement for Bearman.
Copy.
He only went green in sector 3. Taking 10 places and 20 on Albon.
The time has almost come for our driver.
It's P20 to P1 challenge here. We'll switch back to the used parts. Try for the one-stop strategy. But that could evolve into a two-stop depending on what everyone else is doing. Or, you know, safety car, etc. Under fuel by one lap. And max pace here. Save the game.
We've got 44 laps ahead of us here in Spa as we get ready for the Belgian Grand Prix. We look now to Esteban Ocon, who's clearly ready and raring to go.
19th isn't a great way to start this one off, but let's see what they can do in the race.
But remember, anything can happen in Formula One. You can hear the excitement in the crowd here at the Belgian Grand Prix. It's lights out and away we go.
It's too rarely defend medium aggression.
It's critical we overtake.
Drop it.
Should also try to manage tire temperatures from the start. We do the drive and clean air trick, maybe get a cheeky overtake. Go for high aggression. Now the cars are a little bit spread out.
Okay.
We stayed behind Maloney a little too long there. But, Lawson had an issue. Now Maloney's back. What the hell? Bring this down to a 3.5 kilo delta. And switch to standard.
Let's take a look at the replay. Now, Alex Albon is part of this. The gap opens up for them. And Alex Albon completes the move.
Yeah, that's pretty good. Still, though, being stuck behind Sargeant. This is painful. Come on, Behrman. This is painful and risky. Oh no, lockup.
Keep pushing.
I think I'm so early.
Keep pushing.
Damn. Well. It didn't destroy the tires that much. But whatever advantage we had on them is gone. Alright, finally passed Sargeant. Now Perez. Come on, it's a Mercedes. We can get past this guy. Behrman doing incredible right now. Peak confidence. Yeah, after that lockup, I don't know. Almost 9 laps wasted. Looks like Ferrari's having a great day. Ferrari 1-2 with Max on a 4-second gap. 3.5-second gap. Lando up into P4. Sainz. Look at Teo. Teo P8 in the Haas. Lawson had that lockup, and that really set him back even further than Albon. Whoa!
Okay, there's a big crash.
Ocon, Maloney, bang wheels.
Be careful for debris.
And yes, yes we have. We've had a crash. What happened there?
That's one way to get places back on track. Maloney with the penalty. No penalty for Ocon. Does he have damage? Looks like he's got wing damage. Oh man, he's missing his entire front wing. That's all gone. Five-second penalty.
Is good.
Yeah, copy.
Now what happened there, Karun?
The Alfa Romeo team there standing by. But we see the issue occur here.
That's just the penalty. He couldn't get one of these tires off though. Come on, Alba, how are you gonna let Sergeant pass you like that? He has a tire advantage, that's why.
The window is open.
Copy.
Check the DRS.
Yep, okay.
We start using curbs and then just try to spend whatever we have in the tire. Alright, we pit Behrman next lap. We go Albon right now. keep it in attack for a little bit just to get the tires up to temperature. Like everyone's doing the one stop. It's the second lockup for Lawson.
Now this is what happened as they took turn 8. The wheels just lock up there. Now they did leave it very late.
Probably gonna have to start conserving some fuel here. There's just been no safety cars.
Karim Chandon, talk us through this one.
Ferrari's team prepared for the stop. But there's a problem jacking up the car.
Oh, that's a terrible pit stop mistake.
Need to increase lifting coast.
I felt like forever. Alright, Albon should have DRS from Behrman. Did a bit of DRS trading here. Actually, Albon's got DRS from Gasly now. Yo, Joe, what's up? How's it going? Cool. Yeah, we're doing pretty well here. started in... We had to take a grid place penalty for new powertrain parts. But, started P20 and P16, now we're up into P8, P9. So we're making a comeback. Just hope we have enough fuel here. Basically just conserving fuel, trying to get the fuel delta back to zero.
Yellow flag here.
The tires are getting a bit hot. trying to keep the cars together, but Albon is just faster. I want Behrman to be within 1 second of Albon, so they can get the DRS.
Fuck, he's full.
Okay, he's got full battery. Okay, Behrman's back within 1 second. Okay, fuel delta is back to 0.2 kilos, so we can go back to a balanced fuel pace. Now Albon is 1.7 seconds off from the next car ahead. Could deploy the battery. This should be an easy P7 coming up. Try to go on the inside, but yeah. Close the door for that. Oh, come on. So close. On the inside? Nope. There you go, on the inside. Okay, now you can avoid clean air. Alright, Stroll is up next, 3.3 seconds away. Not even attacking with the tires. Probably attack for a little bit. Attack until the tires get to about 110. Once they hit 110, get back off. Well, I got overtaken over here. That's not good. We're almost, yes, there it is. Within 1 second of car ahead.
Packs on the low side now. Okay, happy to manage tire short term.
It did cost all of the battery that we had, though. Joe, I don't know if you're familiar with Formula 1, but... yeah, these green sections on the track here, those are the DRS zones. The DRS is the drag reduction system. So that when you're in the zone, if you're within 1 second of the car ahead, it lets you open up the rear wing. As you can see there. Therefore reducing drag and then allowing you to make an easy pass on the straight. But that's only if you're within 1 second of the car ahead of you. Driving clean air and get around them. There you go, right up the inside. Easy pass. Alright, next up is Sainz and the Red Bull. 1.4 seconds away. Attack for a little bit here. Get within 1 second. Okay, we should have DRS in the next one. Keep attacking. Clean air. Right, easy pass on the inside. Back to standard pace. I'm just going to make sure he doesn't overtake us.
There's a yellow flag now. Right, so this was the fourth corner. And that's the moment the car plows into the wall.
That was too close. Rebound off the wall. If he just slid a little bit further on the track, it could have been a massive accident. But yeah, so the DRS, I guess it does allow for cleaner overtaking, so you don't have to, you know, you could be a bit more strategic with your overtakes on the straights rather than through the corners. But, you know, drivers still get overtaken in the corners, it's just, you know, another way for them to do so. Yeah, I guess it arguably is safer. But yeah, we put a 1.5 second gap on Sainz, so we don't have to worry about him anymore. Alright, only 3 laps to go. I don't think we're gonna clear 9 seconds to Norris ahead. We got went from P20 to P5. It's pretty good. Probably just keep aggressive on this. Right, final lap here coming up. We did close the gap about 1 second there. But yeah, unfortunately, the race is coming to an end. But yeah, from P20 to P5, it's pretty damn good. Yeah, basically the reason why I had to start P20 was because I bought new powertrain. I bought and used a new engine and battery. I used them in the qualifying session. So when you use a new battery, you have to take a 10 place grid penalty, and then when you use a new engine past the allotted amount, which is three engines and two batteries.
Russell wins it! First over the line.
You go past that amount, then you have to take a penalty for the race start. I believe a new gearbox is only a 5-place penalty. It's not as severe for gearbox.
Okay, check a flag.
P5. Really solid job there, mate. I think you did well.
The best we could have done. Yeah, well done, everyone.
Check a flag.
Alright, both drivers in the points. It's 1 point for Behrman. Was that 8 for Albon?
Now that's a really fantastic result for the Williams driver.
I tell you what, they had to work hard for those points today. What a phenomenal achievement that is.
A great display of team spirit there, as everyone finally gets the chance to share this moment. And right now, it's the British driver who proudly takes his place on the podium.
That's their second win of the season.
Double Ferrari podium.
A brilliant talent who looks so at home on the track.
So Albon up 15 points. Or 15 places, got 10 points for P5. Behrman up 6. For 1 point. And Albon is still leading the driver's championship with 250. Verstappen is kind of far away at this point. We'd have to have a major crash in the DNF or something, I think, for Verstappen to overtake us. But yeah, Ferrari coming in with 44 points that race. 359 to 305. Dude, yeah, I mean, the sponsorships and the ads, that's all Formula One, man. It's big money. Or, I mean, it's Oracle Red Bull. Oracle Red Bull. It's AMG Petronas, Mercedes, Aston Martin, Cognizant, Formula One team, or Cognizant, Aramco, BWT, the best water technology for Alpine. It's big money in Formula One. Okay, so yeah, we did buy a new engine for Albon that cost $5 million. Sponsorship money pretty much wiped out. We still have a lot of money in the bank. Boardroom upgrade completed. all the facilities are still in the 100% effectiveness range. Of course, we had a fire in the design center, so the design center is shut down. Okay, gotta replace the parts because they failed inspection. Designing any new parts for the rest of the season, I think, so probably gonna need to manufacture another underfloor. Yeah, let's manufacture two more, actually three. 1.2 million, we have 32 million in the cost cap. Need more front wings pretty soon here. As far as the chassis, 76%. Suspension is okay for now. But yeah, thanks Joe for hanging out. See you next time. Scouting completed. Who's currently the youngest driver on the grid? Ricardo Rizzo. Herbert Winkler. Bridget Rue. These are all AI generated, I'm pretty sure. Ivana Duda. Carmela Colombo. F1 in school's invitation. Staff development paused for 7 days for an extra 100,000. Nah. I have $52 million in the bank here, so. And our cost cap, yeah, it's down to $23 million. Can't design anything new because of the shutdown. Right, but, this is what next race is going to be. Get more ATR hours, or CFD hours, whatever. Alright, we can finally resume design and research. Okay, we have ATR hours again. So we need to do a side pod research for next year. We'll use half the ATR hours. For optimized cooling. Just min-max that like that. We're getting 9% benefit. We still have an overall reduction of minus 30, but I'm trying to offset that by doing this research. Driver development update. Albon increased his defending. Behrman has 100 control. Anyone braking. Control smoothness and accuracy for Crawford. So now that he has 100 control, will he finally get other stats? I need him to get overtaking skill. This is worst stat is bringing his overall rating down. Pit crew training. It's going to be a terrible race coming up. Dutch GP. Pit crew is exhausted. Or they will be exhausted. 31% chance of a mistake. So they're going to need extra rest after these races. Instead of gym time, maybe pit stop drills. No, still gonna need more rest. Days of rest after the race, and then the next day focus on gym training. This is not looking good as far as their exhaustion. It's only going to recover for Singapore. Alright, Dutch GP is up next. Two drivers into Q2. Is it one driver fifth or better? Try to get a podium. Try to get one driver on the podium for two races. I think that's going to be it for me tonight.
Hello, and a very warm welcome.
Looks like we got moderate rain coming up for the race, so... Oh, it's also a sprint race. So we got... qualifying in cloudy conditions, and then... a sprint race in light rain. Could be interesting. And I'll save that for tomorrow. And, yeah, I'll be back then. Maybe around the same time, possibly earlier, depending on what I'm doing, but, yeah. Thanks everyone for, following and subscribing. VOD watchers, if you're out there, appreciate you as well. YouTube, thanks for, liking, subscribing. I'll see you next time. Have a good night.